Hello students, now we will be focusing on our assignment, which is here assignment number 5, that is partial class and static class. Okay, first of all we will discuss with static class, we will try the practical of the static class, then we will discuss about the practical partial class, and then we will do the practical of partial class. Now for the static class, first of all start with the console application. I have started with the console application, and the name given is console application static class. Now normally class contains member variables and the methods, which can have scope as private, public, protected as per the requirement, which can have private methods, which can have public methods. Private methods we can call from the public methods and all, and public methods we can call with respect to object. We can have the class with static methods also. Some methods may be statics. And then those static methods we can call with respect to name of the class. But suppose now we have all the methods as a static within a class. So we can create that class as a normal class, just like this class calculations, or you can say maths calculations. And in that we can declare static methods, public static integer get factorial of number n, like this. So we want to create multiple methods, and all methods are of type static. So in such case, instead of creating the simple class, we can create the static class like this. So instead of creating simple class, I have created a static class, and in which I have written two methods, get power and get factorial. Power takes two parameters, x and n, and factorial takes only one parameter. This is x raised to n and this is n factorial. Okay. And in main program, now, I try to read value for x and n. Now, I want power, that is x raised to n, and n factorial. Already, we have created a class in which we have written the static method get power and static method get factorial. Both methods are static, so I have declared class also as a static. Now, when it is a static class, we cannot create the object of that class because all methods are static. Static methods we can call with respect to directly class. It is not necessary to create instance of a class, that is object of a class, and with respect to object call the methods. Static method we call directly. So to call the method, I have written here maths calculations dot get power, and I am passing value of x and n, and then maths calculation get factorial, I am passing value of n, and to get the answer I have converted this p into the double divided by f. So we will be getting x raised to n, p is nothing but x raised to n, and f is n factorial. So we are getting here x raised to n divided by n factorial, and we are displaying the answer, and this is just we want maximum 4 digits after decimal point. Now if we run this program, it will ask for value of x and n, input value of 2, x as 2, n as 3, and then here it gives you the answer. Okay, so static method, static class is the class which can have only static methods, and those methods we can call with respect to class name directly. We don't create the object directly with respect to class, we are calling this. So we declare the static class only if all the methods or variables are static. Okay, thank you. Try this.